So, what have we got here?
Mysterious meat with onion thingy for you. Mystery meat and bean for me. And veggie thing for you, which I actually think is meat too.
Thanks.
So, where are they?
Minis, I've just dropped them off. They've landed.
Join the Navy. See the world.
No, that is a U.S. Navy model, not SBS. Don't steal our shit.
You sure?
Pretty sure.
Automatic pump time is set to pause in 20 seconds.
15. In 5.
4. 3.
Spot on, Aggie.
The junction is 500 meters ahead of you.
Then it's a straight run for 1.2 kilometers to the target. That should take 20 minutes to swim there and 20 minutes back. Comms are good, tracking is good.
Roger, I confirm.
So what happens if they don't get out before the pump turns on?
Well, the current will carry them through to this junction where they'll most likely be chewed to pieces by the intake pump.
That would suck.
Literally.
You know, we can hear you.
Sorry, boys.
Looking good.
Okay, we're through the junction, making our first turn south. Marty, you keeping up?
This is 1-2, I'm right with you.
Request you check my air stats. My readings are looking way off.
Something's not right. I have you down to 50% air.
Roger, I confirm. I now show 45%. I'm losing air way too fast. There must be something caustic in this water that's eating the seals on our rigs.
Why didn't we know about this?
Or this grating that also wasn't on the schematics.
They've stopped. Stratton?
The intel on this mission is now officially bullshit.
There's nothing on this system.
Hold up! Marty's O-ring has blown. His rig is dead. Repeat, 1-2 has dead rig. He's switching to reserve now. Only 2 minutes on that thing and don't know how long mine will last.
My God, they're just holding their breath.
No, they'll make it.
Still have 300 meters to go.
The pumps are back on.
Come on, come on. Well done.
Abby, we won't be able to use the pipe to get out. We're over there.
Roger.
Moving the extraction to RV2.
Aggie, shouldn't there be guards patrolling this place?
You've seen the satellite photos. Never less than six seen on site in the last 10 days.
No one.
Or they're very, very small.
Zero, charges set.
Roger, out.
Sending the heli to RV2 now.
You need to make your way through the lab building to the rear exit.
Change flight plan to RV2.
Roger that.
Where are the workers? Why is no one here?
This doesn't make sense.
1-1, this is 10-9 inbound with you. Approx figures 1-5.
Still warm. No more than 30. Holy shit.
Hag, are you seeing this?
That's biochem storage.
Well, it was storage. And now it's a fucking crime scene of biblical proportion, and we're standing in it.
We're late. Bio's gone. Shit.
What are you thinking?
I'm thinking right now the only two people in the universe we can trust are each other.
I like it.
Aggie, I'm changing the extraction points again. Negative on RV2.
Extraction team is inbound now to RV2.
No, that's not going to happen. We don't know what's waiting for us there. Extract on me.
Negative. We can't enter Iranian airspace.
No, we have no choice. Just send me the chopper.
Stand by. We'll need to get authorization.
Negative. No time. Just do it.
Roger. Extraction's on you.
Tin Man, this is Zero. Cancel Romeo Victor 2. Extraction is now on call sign 1-1. Confirm my last. Over.
Roger. Extraction is now on call sign 1-1. Out.
Hot zone, hot zone. Do you agree, hot zone?
Yep. Move.
Charging!
is the fucking exit!
Thank you. Why don't you ever drink your own booze?
Where's the fun in that?
Some noise at your place the other day. Someone killed a cat.
She took my pewter beer mug.
Yep, gone for good. I thought she was going to firebomb that pathetic barge of yours. Would have improved the neighbourhood.
I loved that mug. Found on my first dive in Pearl Harbor.
Ah, she was no good for you.
That's not what you said when I brought her around here. You said she was just what I needed.
Well, this is what I'm saying now. Rough one. Hand me my jacket, come on. Let's go down the pub.
What a good man. From Trent.
There was a good man from Trent whose cock was so long that it bent. To save himself trouble, he put it in double. And instead of coming, he went. come on, give me another one.
A horny marsupial named Reeve.
That was your favourite. The boy, a horny marsupial named Reeve, spent some time with the whores between their knees. When they asked him for money, he said, "Listen, honey, a koala eats bushes and leaves."
Night.
Ended up on Justin. Oh. Justin Henry. It's a good name, right? Strong?
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah. I will see him after this one.
Innocent workers here, most of whom live in the nearby town. MRAS
brought up. Thank you.
Hope you don't mind meeting in here. My schedule's quite full.
No, ma'am.
Sergeant Stratton, you're a highly effective operative. You don't have a reputation for respecting authority or the chain of command. You changed protocol in the middle of a mission, against orders. I trust you've seen this firestorm.
Not on television. No, ma'am.
I'm very sorry about Sergeant Sturgis. His is a great loss.
They're waiting for us, ma'am. Whoever they are knew we were coming and purposely engaged.
And made off with what we were supposed to destroy, I'm afraid. Not only do they possess the bio, but we, and by extension Washington, look like international war criminals. I haven't felt rage like this from all sides in my entire duration.
I'm prepared to accept any penalties for violating protocol, ma'am.
I'm glad to hear you say it, Sergeant, but that won't be necessary. Even without the violation of airspace, once civilians were killed, Iran, Russia, Hezbollah, they were all going to blame us. The bottom line is, there's an unknown amount of WMD out there. And whoever took it, I for one am quite concerned about their abilities.
Yes, ma'am. They were very organized.
And we shall be too. I just needed to see that your head is on straight. I'm afraid the rage on this is just getting started.
Where's the chopper?
Let's get it out, sir. Hold on.
Yeah, the aerial UV readings.
you find anything I didn't report? It was an in-the-moment call, Aggie. I didn't plan on changing your exit strategy. Someone once asked Napoleon about his battle plans. He said, show up and see what happens.
You? Napoleon?
Yes, much taller and a slightly better dancer. So I've been told.
You're right. Probably saved every life from that extraction team.
Well, you would have done exactly the same.
I was on the ground. Doesn't make it any easier to be wrong. Horrible.
Stratton. We'd heard you'd been suspended.
No.
Someone said Spinks and I are trying to find out where this leak is. Mission logs, wiretaps, anything prior to the mission.
Those guys, somehow they knew we were coming. Stop there, go back.
What?
He was in charge.
No, Steve Larry.
Yeah, it's not clear enough for facial recall.
Can you try a different frame? Or can you clean that one up?
Be a lot quicker without you breathing down my neck.
Sergeant Stratton, please.
This way.
Should have gone back. For the birth, at least.
And let you have all the fun. You Stratton?
You must be Marty's replacement.
You can't replace Marty.
I'm going over your file. It's impressive.
Thank you. Heard a lot about you too, sir.
You can cut the sir. Everyone calls me Stratton.
You served two tours in Afghanistan with Mako 30 at Takagar.
Pretty hairy.
It was interesting.
Is Marty your company CO?
Yes, sir.
You close?
More than close. I came in green and Marty saved my ass more than once. We were together pretty much the whole time. He's a good man.
He's a very good man. So in your file, you turned down three other assignments and a promotion for this one. May I ask why?
You go where you think you can do the most good, right?
Yeah, well, if I get a hint that you're here looking for vengeance for Marty, I'm going to send your ass back to the States.
I can handle myself.
I don't give a shit about that. Your mind goes anywhere other than the moment at hand. You're a risk. I'm not getting my ass shot off because you're pissed off about Marty. Is that clear?
Crystal.
You've been called to MI6. You Petty Officer Munro?
Yes.
Welcome to the Special Boat Service. You'll be joining Sergeant Stratton.
I'd get changed if I were you.
Rick.
We have an unknown quantity of a biological weapon called Satan Snow floating around somewhere out there. One of the most lethal airborne pathogens of which we're currently aware. What do we know?
No terror organization is taking credit. I mean, they're more content with us taking the fallout.
And obviously the Iranians won't share any intel that might prove otherwise.
We're attempting to ID this figure, brought to our attention by Sergeant Stratton. Caucasian male, approximately 50 years of age.
He seemed different. Gave orders, controlled the gun battle.
Tried every database available, but didn't get a match.
His name is Gregor Borovsky, FSB. He specialized in counterintelligence in Europe. Responsible for the deaths of 9 MI6 agents. Single most dangerous man I've ever met.
CV like that. Why didn't he show up on facial recognition?
Because he's former FSB. He's been dead for 20 years. If Borovsky's alive, Stratton, Cummings, follow me. Because Borovsky was such a disruptive force and a rising star within the FSB, MI6 put together a task force to take him down. In 95, we put an operation in motion to out Borovsky as a double agent. It was successful. We turned the FSB on their best operative. We gathered intel later that year that he'd been assassinated by his own people. He's been presumed dead for 20 years. I cannot stress how dangerous Borovsky is and how resourceful. With the security breach, we need to keep it tight and fast. I'll deal directly with Interpol. Stratton will lead any field ops. MI6, focus on who might buy or use biokens and run support.
Support? Sorry, when did Special Forces start making calls for MI6?
Let's leave our egos out of this. If not, Borovsky's gonna eat us alive.
Yes, ma'am.
So far, 148 victims have been found, although search teams warn that that figure is likely to grow.
Satan's snow.
This is only a ground-level deployment.
Only?
This cyclosirenage is designed for high-altitude disbursement. At, say, 1,000 feet, it could cover an area 100 times the size of this village.
Well, it seems like a primitive test to taunt us, rather than a sales pitch to unload the stuff.
To really use and disperse requires complex chemistry and tech.
There are only two bomb makers we know of likely able to completely weaponize the substance. Adnan Homsey. His last known location is Aleppo, but it's questionable whether Borovsky would risk entering a war zone. And Tariq Alawi.
Interpol last place is Alawi in Rome, but this photo's a few years old. No one's got eyes on him since.
Cross-referencing with MI5 shows that Alawi did work for the KGB.
Sounds like all roads lead to Rome. Let's hit the field.
I agree. He's our most viable choice.
Men, women, children, entire families cut down mid-strand.
That's him.
Yeah, I see them now.
Good on man plus one. 500 meters out, Alawi and one bodyguard.
Got him.
Let's go.
Meters in closing at walking speed.
Tariq Alawi.
Just Alawi, no need for first name.
Here's another name for you. Hashd Bandi?
Yes, what about it?
Well, the CNN version is that the Brits accidentally scorched an Iranian pharmaceutical factory.
Yeah, not without the nod from America.
I don't give a fuck about the politics. I think you and I both know what was really there.
Not cancer research?
Cycloserin. Satan's snow. And I think we both know that it wasn't destroyed, but stolen and transported from Iran.
Look, here's what I think. If you were going to arrest me, I would already be on a transport to an American pit where they would pour water down my throat. But here I am, so why don't you just get to the point?
We need information. You were hired to build a biological weapon recently.
Okay, I'm not gonna bullshit you. I know what you do, you know what I do. I build weapons for many people. People who want to blow up their businesses, their boats, or their wives, mainly for insurance.
Or terrorists to kill whoever they please.
Yes, a client of mine. He hired me to make a dispersal device.
A dispersal device?
Liquid into vapor. Very lightweight.
You say what it was for? Where or when?
What do you mean, like, don't be in Times Square on the 9th at 2:30? No. He pays, I make. People die, not my problem.
You're responsible for the deaths of thousands of people. You're about to be responsible for the deaths of hundreds of thousands.
I'm no different to you. I just don't pretend it's for a good cause.
An associate of mine is taking this. He's a US Navy SEAL sniper. Of course, I can't tell you his name, but I can tell you he was the highest scoring marksman in his unit 5 years in a row. Besides the camera, he has a DMR. Semi-automatic gas operated. Chambered for the 7.62 by 51 millimeter NATO cartridge. 600 meters is an easy shot.
He looks like you.
What is he? 5? 6 years old? I think we'll start with him.
No.
First target's the boy.
No.
Roger that.
No, please, please. Not my boy, please.
Do you have the target in your sights?
I have a clear shot.
Okay. You look for a drone guy.
On my command.
Okay, okay. Greco, this is your man. He's Russian, but he uses a local name. He makes dentist stuff. Drills, micromed.
Where is he?
He has a workshop across the Tiber. That's all I know, I swear. That's all I know. Please.
Why don't you speak to your boy? Tell him Daddy's all right.
Farid Ibni?
On second thoughts.
Hello? Me?
Pick a number between 1 and 3.
2.
Good answer. Greco?
Greco.
So what's the deal with Stratton?
What do you mean?
You've worked with him before. What's he like?
I've only worked with him twice, including Nagul. Reserved, I suppose. Keeps his cards close to his chest.
Reserved? Marty never described him as reserved.
You knew Marty?
Yeah, I did.
He and Stratton seem to get on.
Marty never would have followed Stratton unless he trusted him. I had a nose like a Tennessee hound dog. He just seemed to know if you were right or not.
He wasn't responsible for Marty's death, if that's what you're implying.
Sorry. I didn't think I was implying anything.
It's definitely his place. Top floor. Front's too exposed, so we'll go around the back.
Let's go.
Stratton, our drone maker's early. Greco's entering the building and he's brought Muscle with him.
I've got him too.
Bodyguards. Means he's expecting someone.
Stratton?
All right.
From the machine, it's all I could find.
Thanks.
Hang on. I think we've got something. It's too dark for an ID.
It's gotta be him. That's Borovsky.
We should grab him right now.
Wait. It's useless to us without the bullet.
Ты как заходи. Здесь у нас, видишь, как дома. Будь как дома.
You've brought some friends. Different definition of trust, I see.
No, just a little precaution. I'm sure you could understand.
See? That's him, right there.
The target location is preset on all four drones.
Within a 2-mile radius of the target, enter the launch code. GPS will lock. You then have 5 minutes.
You know well, Gregor, no one else could have done this for you the way I did. But I've been working hard on these drones and want to make sure I'm compensated properly, you know? I don't know what you're talking about.
Again, who is watching?
Блядь, Грегор, что ты делаешь? Это же можно, блядь! I didn't say anyone! I would never betray you, Грегор, please! Блядь, get over again, so... Look, take this fucking drone and just please go away. I don't want any trouble. Please, Gregor.
For courage.
No!
is he looking for?
Us.
Just be sitting here. We should take him right now.
We don't have enough manpower. We need full support, Stratton.
We're going to follow him to the chemicals, then we're going to take him down. Aggie, you can call ops for backup.
Wait! Wait! Fuck it!
Changing mags!
Aggie, block that bag!
Shit.
I quite like this park. It's a memorial to ordinary people who died while trying to save others. William Donald, Bayswater, age 19, railway clerk, was drowned trying to save a lad from a dangerous entanglement of weeds. A dangerous entanglement of weeds. The Victorians had a way with words, didn't they? What went wrong in Rome?
Borofsky spotted us.
Analysis of what you got from Greco?
Evidence from the workshop suggests the drone we secured was one of four built for him. I believe Borofsky has the other three and the bio.
The target?
Until we can crack the guidance module on the drone we have, it's unknown to us.
Assuming, of course, that all four drones had the same target.
Yes, exactly. I've been going over Borofsky's file. One name. Sergei Orlov?
Broska's handler back then.
You knew him? Mm-hmm. He was put in charge of Borowski's assassination.
His own friend and boss, Orlov, signed his death warrant.
Once it was done, he quickly rose through the ranks. In fact, 2 months ago, he was appointed as the new Minister of the Interior.
Fast track to the Prime Minister's job.
President, if he plays his cards right.
Keep your crutch. Friend.
But I was your friend. A true friend would have let them carry out this sentence? Put a bullet into your head? I let you live.
So Orlov doesn't kill his friend, he stashes him somewhere out of loyalty.
And now I will magically lift this exile. The British are targeting a chemical facility in Iran. We require it to fail. We need some help on this one. Maybe it will lead to a way out in the future. Dead British soldiers found on Iranian soil would be a political coup for Moscow. The money to finance this operation is in my car. Leave the bio on site. Make it look newsworthy.
Except he went missing 3 weeks ago. Years go by. Broska stews. Waits for the right moment.
For his revenge.
So Borowski's gone rogue and kept the bio for his own use. Come on, Stratton. Stop dancing around it. Why don't you ask me?
Much of Borowski's file was classified. I put it together with some other sources and did some intelligent guessing. One name kept cropping up.
I was a young field agent when I was approached by my superiors to join the operation to discredit Borowski. I went to Cairo, made contact with Borowski, and convinced him I was ready to turn. For 5 months, I gave up false information from MI, while he watched me, feeling me out to see if I was lying. Things turned romantic. I suppose I seduced him, gained his trust, and then, following orders, I framed him as a double agent. This may be personal.
Strike a blow to his former boss?
Or I could still be in love with him. Working with him from the inside. Stratton, you're my best and brightest. I trust you'll figure out which.
What is this?
I figured after Rome I'd be relieved. Just thought I'd get a head start.
You're under my command until further notice.
You gave me a shot and I blew it. I almost got you, the rest of the team, and a whole bunch of other people killed. I'm surprised I haven't been brought up on charges yet. Sorry?
Come on.
Tell me again, why you want to rebuild the engine of a boat that'll probably fall apart with a vibration as soon as you start it up?
Is it unnatural for a boat not to sail?
Oh, is this the new Yank?
Hank, this is Ross.
Pleasure to meet you, sir.
Yeah, you can call me sir when I've been knighted. Any day now, they tell me. Well, know anything about being on the water?
Hank's a Navy SEAL.
You ask him if he knows about being on the water. I don't care what he knows about being under the water. Spent most of my life avoiding it. Never saw the attraction.
Well, my parents have a 35-footer out off Monteo. Spent most of my summers on it growing up.
Oh, well, well, I am impressed. 35-footer, you say? Mm-hmm. Yeah. All fitted out nice. Yeah. Curtains. A nautical theme your mum picked up. Blue and ivory. Cute little sailing boats and the like, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, pardon me while I fart la vie en rose.
He likes you.
The Queen.
The Queen.
You know, I remember distinctly. First time I met that young codfish. Couldn't have been more than 9 years old. Always hanging about the lock. Yeah, took pity on him finally. One day when I found myself in need of ballast. His parents had died when he was young. They put him into care in North London. Staff got a family here to take him in, but he was really raised down here on the boats by this wreck of a human. My third wife, consummate bit from Mumbai, took a special liking to the boy. I always felt he was too good for the life. Put him on the worst jobs, cleaning the day's catch. Tried to discourage him. Yeah, he loved it.
And what do you think he liked about it?
Well, everything. And the sea, of course. I love getting up before the sun, freezing bloody cold, bundled up so I could barely move. I love the old men and their crass jokes. They're the kind of men you could trust your life with, and you did.
Initial decipher on the module, these numbers appear to be possible course directions and altitudes.
But not the GPS coordinates.
It's the code for the coordinates. But we do know the flight pattern for this particular drone.
Presumably the other three drones that Porovsky acquired have similar modules.
Program flight patterns, but no longitude or latitude to narrow down the targets.
And without those longitudes and latitudes, we have no idea where it would actually be launched from.
We can make out a bit of a waterway here, but that's it. There's nothing else.
Have you attempted to enhance the image?
It's pixelated, frozen as is.
We have attempted to match it to Italian cities. Any with a sizable river like Rome or Florence, but none remotely fit, so it's likely...
It's likely Porovsky's on the move.
All the quicker, now he knows about us.
Three drone crates, the weapon canisters. He's had ample time to arrange transport out of Italy.
Porovsky's murders in Ukraine are likely a statement. After all these years, he's out for vengeance, telling the Russians, I could destroy you. Since this image could very well be Moscow, I'm going to have to share this intel and ask for their help. Cummings, you'll coordinate that effort once I have clearance from Downing Street in Washington.
Yes, ma'am.
So Porovsky's not too far gone.
You're in shock, Agent Cummings, as you should be. Your handler, Olof, is dead, and now you're my mole, my MI6 traitor. In case you doubt the danger you're now in, I have a duplicate of this file ready to send to your esteemed boss, Gisela Sumner. Your task is to return the device that your colleague stole from me in Rome. It holds a secret that must not be discovered by them. The longer it remains with your agency, the greater the risk to my mission. I will have my revenge, and you just may survive, if you do as I say.
Messages? On your desk, Mom.
Thank you.
Morning.
Mom?
Cummings. The P PM and Washington are back-channeling any joint investigation with the Kremlin. You and I liaise.
Of course, yes. Sooner the better. I think I may have found what you've been looking for, though, Mark.
A bit more detail, Cummings.
In regards to the intelligence share with Moscow and getting something out of it, I know this is a big concern of yours, so I found this. This is an American journalist who's been held captive almost a year now in Chechnya.
Thomas Miller.
Yes.
I believe Moscow has denied any knowledge of his whereabouts, which is, of course, nonsense.
Absolutely. Getting his release in exchange for our intel share, that would go a long way with the Yanks. Maybe even erase some of the embarrassment of the Iranian cock-up. Well,
I would count it as returning a kidnapped victim to his family, but I shall make the call. Thank you, Cummings.
Thank you, Mark.
Says here Miller weighed 81 kilos before the Chechens grabbed him. Bet you he's lost, what, 8 or 9 on hostage rations?
A bit of medicines and food for him at the embassy.
Do the Russians even have a word for plan? There's Miller, finally.
What the hell was that? You just shot your own... Who the fuck are you?
Shaolin. I guess that kung fu didn't come in too handy over there.
The fuck? No! No, you can't do this! No! No!
Spirit of cooperation?
You're Strutton, right? I'm Borodin Pavel. This is Agent Volkov.
I'm slightly more interested in Mr. Miller. No offense.
Of course, of course. You have the module. Well, he's a little worse than expected. These Chechens come wanting to ruin his return, we suppose. You know, no photo op.
Mr. Miller? Mr. Thomas Miller. From Indianapolis, Indiana. I will get you cleaned up back at the embassy. Your cab did do this to you before your release.
It did, but I'm okay.
The drone control module and all our files on Gregor Borowski.
He's a very dangerous man, but we will handle him.
Cowboy up.
That went completely fucking pear-shaped. Where does Borowski even start pulling off something like that?
I'm not sure, but I have some idea. Aggie, can you get someone on a secure line? Coming back.
I'm willing to hear your reasoning, Sergeant, of course.
Our primary is the ambush in Hashbandi. It was clear Borowski knew we were going to be there in advance. Secondary is yesterday's exchange with the alleged FSB. Again, there were warnings. Both were top-level, highly classified missions. The only person outside these walls who knew of both was Agent Cummings.
And in line with Sergeant Stratton's new thinking on the drone module, it was also Agent Cummings who suspended our research in that area.
The first time got Marty Sturgis killed. And yesterday, we were lucky enough to get out...
Do I need to say how serious these accusations are? What are we talking about, Stratton?
We know that Borowski is in possession of 4 weapon canisters, but only 3 drones. His operation yesterday took extensive effort and time. Extensive effort and time for...
For a module he no longer needs.
On the surface, yes. Surely if a man like Borowski wanted to stop us handing it over, it must have a value we missed.
Restart all efforts on the module. Tear it to pieces. Find what we're missing.
Already begun, Mum. We're downloading the material as we speak.
I'll deal with Agent Cummings. Cummings is gone. Security logs show him swiped out, and of course his phone is off.
He'll be headed for Borowski.
Borowski and the drones must remain the priority.
Yes, Mom.
Hey, Abby, look at this. No longitudes and latitudes. It's just rotated. No, it's inverted. It's resolving, giving us the target.
Oh, my God. London. Sumner's office. These are pre-programmed command modules. Once one is launched, there's no need for a human guide.
So if Borofsky gets any of those drones airborne, he can vanish immediately.
He's been coming here all along.
Thames Estuary, you may have something. At 0600, MCA reports contacting a shipping vessel for violation, for shutting down its tracking beacon.
Did they board and search?
The ship's captain complied almost immediately, claiming a brief electrical failure, but before a unit was sent out.
Mm-hmm. MV Baffin Street, out of Amsterdam. Track it down and send its location to SBS. It looks like it's received docking permission for Canary Wharf, East London.
Ground assistance, ma'am.
Send the nearest two units. Have them coordinate with Stratton.
This is Dolphin 1. Listen for orders. Dolphin 2, confirm task of assaulting ship from port side. Dolphin 1 and 3, primary task to secure 3 bioweapon drones. Prevent X-rays from leaving ship area with drone weapons. Any puncture to drone casing will cause gas to release. If this does occur, they must be destroyed with your LAW heat round. Heat is the only way to destroy the fire. I see two drones, one quayside, one on crane.
Let's move!
Come on!
shot of Morovsky! The drone's in the way! Fucking bridge! Morovsky's gone into the canal system. Zero, I want a vehicle to Surrey Quay now. We'll continue search on land.
You know Borowski is finished. You should have run while you had the chance.
Aggie, listen, all right? I never wanted it to come to this. This was never supposed to happen. This was never part of my plan, all right? You do trust me. You have to believe me.
There's a special place in hell for you. For you and for Borowski.
Take the next left. Take the next left. There.
We took two drones out of play, Stratton.
Maggie?
Let me take you in.
Help us find the drone. It's not too late.
Stop.
Please. You know, he tricked me. He blackmailed me. Not even all off of the FSB knew what he was unleashing with Borowski. This wasn't how it was supposed to finish. I never agreed to any of this.
Then don't do it. You don't have to do this.
Yeah, I do. You see over there? That's what you're looking for. Ah, Aggie. I don't want to do this.
What is it? What is this place?
Are you all right, son? Aggie, can you hear me? Are you all right?
Cummings is dead. He was trying to show me something.
Fucking hell. Go.
Off Camden High Street, I think.
Spinks, get a trace on Aggie's phone.
Canal Street Garage.
Canal Street Garage.
Lime Street has to be.
Thank you.
eyes on the drone.
Anything you recognize, any buildings, any monuments.
Come on, Aggie, give us something.
Trafalgar Square, Nelson's Column.
Ah, so many buses.
Hang on, I have an idea. Stratton, look out for a camera flash.
How close is the bus?
She should be there. Her signal's right on top of yours.
There she is. Top deck, number 9 bus, right there.
Okay, we've got the bus. We're in pursuit.
Aggie, we have you.
Spinks, we're following them into the park.
Dispatching CTU now, ETA 4 minutes.
Okay, this is the best option to take him down. Fewer people than on the streets.
You're authorized to engage.
Let's take them. Where are you off to?
3 weeks R&R. Which for me means my sofa, a good book, and tea.
Oh, that sounds very nice right about now.
That it does.
You know, we couldn't have put this together without you.
Thanks, John.
Well, over the next few weeks, while you're recovering on your sofa, you might feel the need for dinner and something a little stronger than tea.
If I do, I think you should remember what a wise man told me about Napoleon.
What was that?
Show up and see what happens.
Where are they sending you next?
Well, I was thinking that I would hang around here for a while. I like the weather. Plus, they send me back home and I'll just get into more trouble.
Wouldn't want that.
You were right, by the way.
About what?
About Marty. Even with everything that happened, it's not enough.
No. No, it never is.
Still, it's pretty good.
Come on, you two, there's fishing to be done.